שמי מוטי סגב, אני הייתי ראש ועדת אדמס בשלוש שנים האחרונות, ולפני זה זה שלוש שנים שהייתי חבר הוועדה, והיום זה ערב האחרון שאני מוביל במסגרת פעילות אדמס. And I will switch to English in a moment, just to make it easier for Julian. אתה מבין?
כן.
אז אם ככה אני אמשיך בעברית. אז לכבוד הוא לנו לארח את הערב הזה כל שנה, ותמיד משפחת אדמס מגיעה לפה בהרכב מלא או חלקי. והשנה יש לנו פה את דוקטור ג'וליאן אדמס, הבן של מרצ'ל אדמס, מי שייסד את קרן אדמס. אנחנו עוד נספר עליו ותראו סרט עליו, וגם אני אספר עליו קצת, וגם הבן שלו יספר עליו קצת, וגם אני אספר על ג'וליאן קצת ועל האחים שלו ואחותו. אבל קודם כל אני רוצה לברך אתכם, לברך את המלגאים החדשים, ולברך את המלגאים הוותיקים, גם את חברי הסגל שפעם היו מלגאים, והיום פרופסורים מאוד מצליחים באוניברסיטאות שלהם. אני רואה פה כמה וכמה מהם, וערב טוב לכולם. דברי הפתיחה תיתן הנשיאה שלנו, שאנחנו מאוד מעריכים, נילי.
תודה רבה, אני שמחה, מאושרת לראות את כולכם, יש הרבה טקסים יפים באקדמיה, וזה טקס מרגש באופן מיוחד. אז, dear friends, Dr. Julian Adams, Adams family, president of the Technion, Professor Peretz Lavie, we are delighted that you are our guest speaker, Professor Moti Segev, the outgoing academic director of Adams Fellowship, and Professor Moshe Oren, the incoming director of the Adams Fellowship, dear recipients of Adams Doctoral Fellowships, dear Adams alumni, dear friends and colleagues. I'm delighted to see you all here at the Israel Academy of Sciences and Humanities on this glorious occasion of the Adams Seminar. I'm grateful to the Adams family for the generous gift which supports this excellent group of doctoral students in science. I came to know Annie and Marcel Adams many years ago while I served as rector of Tel Aviv University. It was very easy to communicate with Marcel. He speaks fluent Hebrew. It turned out that he fought here during the War of Independence. The belief in human mind has led Marcel and his family to generously support various projects at Tel Aviv University, including the Brain Center, Information Systems Center at the Faculty of Management. When I became member of the Academy, I was delighted to see that the support of the Adams family has been expanded and applied to the overall academic activity of sciences in Israel. Indeed, his devotion and the devotion of the whole family to academic excellence have been absolute. Marcel and his family, Linda, Gil, Sylvan, Margaret, and there is another, and Julian. We welcome Julian, are endowed with vision and the ability to translate vision into action. They believe in the young talents of Israeli science. I have the honor and delight of meeting for the first time Dr. Julian Adams, who accomplishes the family's vision, a scientist, a leader, drug developer. Dr. Adams is currently chief executive officer of Gamida Cell, and prior to that, he was chief scientific officer and president of Klal Biotechnology Industries. And I heard your praise through Klal leaders who are our partners in the Blavatnik Award and through our Academy member, Aaron Shechanover, Nobel laureate, who highly appreciates you. So we are delighted to have you here. Adams Fellowships are the most prestigious scholarships for doctoral students in the sciences. And I want to recognize Ruth Arnon She wanted to participate. Unfortunately, she could not. But I want to recognize her. She fortified the project by her contribution to postdoctorate scholarships for women who are Adams Fellowship graduates. This is truly remarkable. We awarded this scholarship 2 years ago and last year, and hopefully it will be awarded next year. So the Adams Committee, headed by Professor Moti Segev, my dear friend, is a guarantee that the best candidates are awarded these scholarships. Indeed, the success of Adams graduates serves as a proof. Many of them pursue academic careers. We have some of them here. And some of them work at the high-tech industry, some as medical doctors. The program is not only marked by its excellence, but by the fact that it has made its fellows a community of scholars united by conferences, symposia, trips, friendship. And this is the time to deeply thank Moti Segev for the excellent leadership and commitment. He will be replaced by another excellent scientist and leader, Moshe Oren from the Weizmann Institute. Welcome, Moshe. And we are grateful to Moti, to past directors and members of Adams committees, and of course, to Batsheva Shor, the administrative director, for her devotion and excellent way in which she manages the program. And finally, on this occasion, we celebrate Marcel's 98th birthday. With much love and gratitude, we wish you, dear Marcel, you'll convey the message, many happy returns. Thank you, dear family Adams. Much success to the new Adams doctoral students, and many thanks to you all. And before I finish, please come, Moti, come over. And now you are burdened with a present. And thank you very much.
So part of the job in leading this committee is to write an address for the students. Every year I write something, and I know that the people generally don't bother to look into the booklet, because the booklet has some nice photographs and so forth. Who reads exactly what the people say? Usually it's just words of blessings and that's it. So this is exactly the reason why I make sure that every time, also in the Adams how do you call it, a seminar occasion in January, we have another Adams Gathering conference. And whatever. So I always made sure to give something, a motivation speech along these lines, which is what I want to do now also in the first, in the next 5 minutes, because you can read it, but just the general idea. So when we come to select the students, never mind that it's a hard selection, whatever, what the purpose of this fellowship is to actually help and support and nurture the next generation of science leaders in the state of Israel. So we will see it as success when you go there and you become leaders in your fields and come back as faculty members. If you go to high-tech industry, that's okay too. But we do not aspire to nurture the next generation of scientists in Columbia or MIT or whatever, or Princeton. We want you to come back here, not because of a commitment, but because you want to be here. And the reasoning behind that, every year, I make sure that it becomes clear to you that you can be a world leader here in Israel. And there are several reasons for that, and every time I talk about it a little bit, so hopefully something of that you carry over with you wherever you go. So when I come and look at it, I don't know if some of you probably know, I was a professor at Princeton University, and I was hired there in 94 as an assistant professor, and within 4 years, I made it through the ranks to full professor. I broke the local record, and then I came back to Israel because I wanted to raise my children here. And the message to you, and still, when I look back, the best part of my work, my scientific work, and the awards that I won was in the work that I did right here in Israel, not at what I did in Princeton. I did well there, but I did much better here. And there are several reasons for that. One of the reasons for that is that in Israel, you have several resources that you don't have even in America. Number one resource for a scientist is time to do research. Many of you will think that the best resource is to have research funding or excellent students or top colleagues. This is not number one. Number one resource is your time. In America, what you do all the time is chase after money, research funding, because every student there is on the order of $50,000, and every postdoc is about $100,000, and a grant from the National Science Foundation in the U.S., the maximum grant is $150,000 per year per investigator. So, and from that, you need to pay your own summer salary and students and so forth. So that means actually that you, if you are a real researcher, that a successful researcher that needs to have something on the order of between 5 and 10 students and postdocs, which is a reasonable size group in the exact sciences and engineering, biology usually bigger than that, you need to raise quite a few million dollars. This means that what you do, you chase the money. Number two resource for a young researcher or researcher in general is the level of the students, and this is where I want to pinpoint that we are blessed with top students, and when I do the comparison between my former students at Princeton and my current students at the Technion, I can say that on average, the level of the students here in Israel is higher than at Princeton, MIT, Caltech, Harvard, and so on and so forth. There are several reasons for that. Part of the reason for that is that here, when you study 4 years of engineering, for example, these are 4 net years of real studies. In America, because you go to college at the age of 18, they see themselves as a part of their mission in college is to educate you, the students, which means that 1/4 of the curriculum, at least, must be in the social sciences and liberal arts, which means that you just, when you count the number of courses, you are missing a year. That's a major thing. Number two, the students in Israel, when they come for a master's and PhD, they are more mature. They know what they want. In America, a kid at the age of 22, I'm not sure, maybe I want to be an entrepreneur. There's nothing wrong being an entrepreneur. But when I look at my PhD students, I want them to know what they want to do. They can't come back every morning and volunteer again and again and again. I want them to know, to be dedicated, to do good work, to be creative. And that brings me to the last thing is also, which is quite rare, somehow in our culture, or education or heritage is the ideas of creativity and the courage to go where nobody has gone before, no one has gone before, is something that is embedded in our culture. Some of that goes back to the arguments in the Talmud, and some of that goes back to the fact that we don't immediately say yes for everything. We don't like to follow orders to the letter. There's a lot of good in that. And this argumentative nature of our people is something that will help you greatly as scientists. So when I tell you now all of this, it's not to praise you or to boost your ego, which I'm sure that you already hear and everybody is happy and so forth, but actually to think ahead, because in 4 years, maybe give or take, when 5 years, when some of you will face the decision whether to come back to Israel or to accept offers from MIT and the like, you'll be at this junction and you'll be worried. Will I be sacrificing something by going back to Israel or staying at MIT? And the answer is that you don't. It depends on you. And it can be done. Yes, we are not perfect. There are some things that we still need to change in universities, in the way that we set up labs to do it faster, to do it more efficiently. And there's quite a few things that we need to change still in the Israeli universities. But we are on a good track. And I think that the hope is there. So I welcome you. I congratulate you for winning the fellowship. And I tell you that this is really what we expect from you when we give you the fellowship. We expect you to come back, to be here, to be our colleagues. And when I look back at my own students, I have already 21 that became professors. 8 of them are right here in Israel. And they are excellent. They are really excellent. So it can be done. So now I want to invite his son, Dr. Julian Adams, to say a few words on behalf of the family.
ערב טוב לכולם. כנראה כולם רוצים לדבר
Banglit, so I'll switch over to for your benefit. That's my dad. I've only known him for 63 years. He's my hero for, you know, what a survivor, actually, and what a life he had, you know. So when I think about my worst day on the planet, you know, it doesn't even compare with the hardships he saw. This was his brainchild, actually. He pulled the children together, the family together, and thought, how could he give back? He was no longer living in Israel, but how could he give back? And I became the only scientist in the family, actually, to disappoint him. I didn't join the family business. But he was very proud of me. And he thought, you know, the future for Israel is innovation, is through science. And he specifically wanted the Adams Fellowships to go not to the humanities, but specifically to science. Because he was a futurist, he believed that young people is where the investment should go, and particularly at the level of seriousness when you go after a PhD program, that's real dedication. And he wanted the best and the brightest. He did not want a meritocracy. He wanted only a meritocracy, not, you know, two for Tel Aviv and two for Jerusalem and two for, you know. He really wanted the best and the brightest. And he told me, you know, who knows, maybe the next Einstein will be funded through this prize. And so it's just an honor for me to represent my family. We're all over the world, I guess, at this time, and I happen to be working. So I'm working here this week in Israel, and it's an absolute honor to meet you, to congratulate you. Kol hakavod lekulchem. Just a few words about Dr. Julian Adams. So he himself has a PhD, and after that, from MIT, if I remember correctly, and after that he invented some major medications against cancer. And right now he is a CEO of a very large company, Gamida. That's what it makes, pharmaceutical company that makes drugs against cancer and other very problematic diseases. So yes, he's not a university professor, but what he's doing there is as important, if not more. So now is the time that we actually give the fellowships. So to the laureates, to the new winners of the fellowships. And I invite Professor Nili Cohen, our president, to join us. And we'll simply ask each one to come. Bacheva, הם מדברים עכשיו או אחר כך? כל אחד לבד בזמן.
ואחרי זה מקבל את
כל אחד לבד.
ומצטלמים.
בסדר. אז נעשה את זה כך. So we do it this way. So first, I'll call the people one by one. So each one of you will present and say a few words, and after that we go up, we give him the... טוב, אז הראשון הוא מיסטר... אדר אדמסקי, מהאוניברסיטה העברית.
Can you hear now? And I also studied the transition from recent to remote memory. We know there is a difference between recent memories, so these are memories that I learned like the day before, to remote memories, things I remember for weeks and months and even years, and I look on different brain regions that support this transition. And my hopes for the future is to advance our understanding of memory. I also hope to maybe with my research to pave the way for the development of new treatments for memory impairments. And I also hope to continue both learning and teaching, being involved in different educational projects, and pass on the new knowledge and skills that I acquire.
ועכשיו אני קורא לגברת איילת ארזי מאוניברסיטת בן-גוריון. ומה עושה איילת ארזי? Brain Research. הבא בתור זה מר ירון בן-עמי מהטכניון, מהאווירונאוטיקה, לסת אווירונאוטיקה וחלל.
PhD in the Faculty of Aerospace Engineering at Technion. I was born and raised in Kibbutz Galed, located in the Menashe Heights region, rises above the southwestern edge of the Israel Valley. My mother was also born in Galed at its early years, daughter to founders of the kibbutz. She retired last year from a practice as a special education teacher after 40 years of teaching elementary school pupils to read and write. She continues nowadays to teach kids voluntarily, as well as monitoring butterfly populations in the region of the kibbutz. My father was born here in Jerusalem a year before the independence war broke. He grew in a Beit Israel neighborhood right next to where the Jordanian border had crossed. He owned a PhD in the field of anatomy and served nowadays as a much loved anatomy lecturer in Haifa University, as well as being a very capable gardener. In my research, I'm investigating the effect of thermal boundary conditions on rarefied gas flows, focusing on the coupling phenomena between the dynamic and thermodynamic description. Rarefied gas flows are encountered when the molecular mean free path and the macroscopic length scales are about the same order. Conditions that are prevailing in micro or nanoscale devices or in low pressure transport vehicles such as high altitude aircraft and the recently developed Hyperloop. My research should aid in analyzing heat and mass transfer processes occurring in such mechanisms. In the future, I hope to continue studying the complex and fascinating field of fluid mechanics. Hope to find new and exciting phenomena and to share my discoveries with the scientific community. Thank you very much.
הבאה בתור היא אנאל בן-אשר, הפקולטה לכימיה בטכניון.
My mother, Sylvie Ben-Asher, is a holistic therapist. In addition, I have four younger siblings who are all currently serving in the army. I am a PhD student at the Technion under the supervision of Professor Nimrod Moiseyev. My research is in the field of non-emission quantum mechanics, which enables the investigation of metastable systems. Such systems are associated with many phenomena in physics and chemistry. For example, there are associated in nuclear physics with radioactive radiation, and in optics with leaky moths in waveguides and optical fibers. In chemistry, they are associated with atomization in which a molecule or an atom gets ionized. In my research, I use non-emission quantum mechanics to explain and interpret quantum phenomena observed in cold molecular collision experiments, in which auto-ionization takes place. In addition, I am working on the development of calculation methods in non-emission quantum mechanics, since such calculation methods are not in abundance. For example, I developed a method for calculation of the energies and the auto-ionization carriers of molecules under an electric field. My hopes for the future is to continue research in quantum chemistry in order to find explanation for chemical process and experiments. It is fascinating to me to find explanation to experiments in chemistry, and I look forward to being ever to discover and predict a new phenomena that will be verified through collaboration with experimental chemistry research teams. Moreover, I would like to encourage more students, in particular female students from the countryside, such as the Galilee where I was raised, to pursue a career in science. Once again, I cannot express to you how important this scholarship to me. Thank you.
עכשיו אני קורא למר יואב לוין, מאוניברסיטה העברית בירושלים, מדעי המחשב.
Thank you very much. My name is Yoav Levine, and I highly appreciate the opportunity to be part of such a distinguished group. I live in Tel Aviv with my wife Gali, but I was born and raised here in Jerusalem. I went to an elementary school that is a member of the Talit chain, which puts an emphasis on liberal Jewish studies and which my grandparents helped found. And continuing my school years at the Leada Hebrew University here in Jerusalem. My father is a professor of Talmud and Jewish history at the Jerusalem campus of the Hebrew Union College. And my mother teaches Tanakh at the Masulti High School and is also a lecturer in the Vivim Tanakh Teachers Training Program at the Hebrew University. So coming from a family of academics in the humanities, my interest in math and science was quite somewhat unexpected, but I'm thankful for receiving the full support of my family in all of my endeavors. My academic studies began with a double bachelor's degree in physics in electrical engineering at Tel Aviv University, where I was a member of the Adi Lautman Special Program for Outstanding Students, and graduated summa cum laude from both electrical engineering and physics department. During my undergraduate studies, I participated in active physics research in a US government particle accelerator facility and also at the Weizmann Institute. And I completed my master's degree in physics at the Weizmann Institute, advised by Professor Yuval Oreg, and together we published a paper in the field of theoretical condensed matter physics. During these studies, I became increasingly intrigued by breakthroughs in the field of artificial intelligence. I was attracted to this field because of its great potential impact on society, but when I approached it and got closer, I found it to be full of unanswered fundamental scientific questions. So therefore, last year, I joined the Deep Learning Artificial Intelligence Theory Group at the Hebrew University, and I'm now a doctoral student of Professor Amnon Shoshua leading the group. Relying on my background in physics, we published two theoretical papers which employ concepts from quantum physics that shed light on recent unprecedented developments in artificial intelligence. And contributing to in the other direction, we published a paper proving that state-of-the-art machine learning algorithms that have facilitated the recent breakthroughs in AI can also help and grant access to currently unattainable many-body quantum physics phenomena. I hope to continue my contribution to this rapidly advancing academic community and to be involved in bringing forward technology that can benefit our society. Thanks again for this great honor.
Next one is, הבא בתור הוא איתי ליניאל מאוניברסיטה העברית בירושלים, שגם לא ממשיך את המסורת המשפחתית, זה עבר לפיזיקה. יש כאלה שגם עושים משהו רציני.
Hi everyone. Again, I thank you for the opportunity and appreciate this great seminar that was put up by Lasheva. So I'm Itai Linial. I'm a graduate student at the Hebrew University, studying astrophysics with Professor Ram Sari. I was born and raised here in Jerusalem, and both my parents are also in the academia. They are professors. My dad is in computer science, and my mom is in biochemistry. And just for the record, my siblings went to the humanities, so but I went to physics. So we each found our own path. So aside from physics, I also enjoy hiking and climbing. And this photo was taken in the Indian Himalayas a couple of years ago when I was hiking there. In my research, I study various problems in theoretical astrophysics. My supervisor, M, also has a wide range of interests, so that allows me to participate in different fields. Recently, I started working on problems related to gravitational waves. So gravitational waves were predicted by Albert Einstein more than 100 years ago, and were first discovered 2 years ago by the LIGO experiment. So gravitational waves are caused by the motion of masses, and they propagate as ripples in the curvature of space-time. Very hard to detect, but now after a few decades of hard efforts, LIGO detected the first gravitational waves, turning it from a theoretical field to an actual data-driven field. So in my research, I'm interested in neutron star mergers, which are the mergers of remnants of massive stars that collide and release a huge amount of energy in the form of gravitational wave and in electromagnetic counterparts that are observable by various types of telescopes. This was first discovered about half a year ago in last August, and the data keeps coming in, and there are lots of open questions related to that, linking the most luminous electromagnetic events in the near universe to gravitational wave events. I'm hoping that this field will continue to bring many opportunities and interesting phenomena, and I hope to continue enjoying what I do and continue teaching and researching in this emerging field. Thank you.
והבא בתור, ערן לוסטיג מהטכניון, שהוא במקרה סטודנט שלי. שלא תחשבו שיש מאפיות, אני ביקשתי מהפקולטה וגם מהטכניון לא להגיש אותו למלגה הזאת, אלא להגיש אותו למלגת קלור, וגם למלגות, או למלגת עזריאלי, אבל עשו לי תרגיל שהייתי בטוח, אמרתי לו, ערן, אין מצב שאתה זוכה. יצאתי מהחדר, ומי שניהל אז את הישיבה היה משה אורן. ככה ערן זכה.
Again, thank you for this scholarship. It's a great honor. So my name is Aran Lustig. My parents are the son and daughter of Holocaust survivors. They came to Israel and lived in Amabara. They both became academics. My father is an aerospace engineer, and my mother is a chemist who became a computer scientist. So we all live in Haifa, and they all studied in the Technion. I'm very connected to where I study, which is the Technion. I became very fascinated in physics from when I was a teen. I read a lot of popular science books, and I decided to dedicate myself to physics. And so I did my degree in physics and electrical engineering. And then I pursued the PhD and the master's degree, and what I studied is, well, there's this field which is called topology, topological physics. And this field shows that materials can exhibit very unique properties like currents that flow without any disorder due to the connection with a mathematical field called topology. So what I did, I built a material that showed this concept in light, but the light does not flow on a very small part of the material, like in all previous materials, but on the entire material. So this was a very new material that showed that light can flow without any perturbations from disorder or any kind of scattering in a material, inside the entire material. And now I completed that research, and it's being under review in a couple of days, I guess. And now I'm pursuing a new experiment, which I want to show how light reacts to extremely strong temporal changes of the material. So this is connecting concepts of time and space, and so how show how light behaves in different ways when space is changed compared to time that is changed. My hope for the future that I will be able to be part of some major discovery that is fundamental in physics and that is very basic in our understanding of the world. And I hope it will serve also humanity, and I am sure it will, like any other discovery of that sort. So thank you very much for this honor.
ואחרון חביב, דוד מס מבר אילן, אוניברסיטת בר אילן, מדעי המחשב.
My research is about high-dimensional expanders. High-dimensional expanders are mathematical objects which possess very strong properties. One example of such property is that on one hand, if you look at every small piece of these objects, they look like a random object. But on the other hand, they also have a lot of structure and symmetries. Now, when one thinks about it, it seems almost impossible because the essence of being a random object is to lack structure. And something that is looks structured is very far from being random. So high-dimensional expanders surprisingly have these two properties all together at the same time. Now, in computer science, both these properties, being random and having a lot of structure, is very useful for many applications, and usually one cannot have both at the same time. And as I mentioned, in high-dimensional expanders, we do have both in some sense at the same time. So as such, they are natural candidates to yield some applications which could not be achieved before their discovery. And what I hope is that my research will contribute to the development of this fascinating field.
אז אנחנו ככה לפני שמתפזרים, לפני שאני מזמין את כולם לארוחת ערב חגיגית, אני רוצה להודות לאלה שאחראים על הערב המהנה הזה, וגם שלמדנו פה משהו, אז קודם כל לבת שבע, ואני גם פה... אז ברמה האישית, אני עובד מול בת שבע כבר 6 שנים, וזה היה לא טריוויאלי בהתחלה, כי בת שבע רגילה לנהל את מנהלי התוכנית, אבל אני לא אוהב שמנהלים אותי, אז זה היה קצת פריקשן בהתחלה, אבל אנחנו היינו חברים מאוד טובים, ואנחנו עכשיו יכולים לעבוד בהרמוניה מלאה, ואני בטוח שהיא תמשיך להיות האימא של התוכנית, ולשמור על קשר עם כולם, ולהזמין את כולם, לדבר עם כולם, היא יודעת מה כל אחד עשה מתחילת התוכנית. כלומר, אם תשאלו אותה עכשיו על מלגאי שזכה ב-2006, היא תדע, והיא תדע בדיוק מה הוא עושה היום. ודאי מדהים העניין הזה. אז אני רוצה ברמה אישית להודות לך מאוד בת שבע על כל הליווי והעזרה וכן הלאה, ועוד הרבה מאוד שנים שתמשיכי להוביל את התוכנית הזאת. ולערב הזה אני רוצה להודות עכשיו להכנת הערב, גם ליעקב שאחראי על כל האודיו ויז'ואל, ולבוב לפידות, ולגליה פינצי, מנהלת האקדמיה, ולצלמת שלנו. עכשיו אני מזמין, אני חושב שזכרתי את כולם. כן. טוב, לנילי אני מודה כל הזמן. אז אני רוצה להזמין אתכם לארוחת ערב חגיגית עם קצת מוזיקה קלאסית ברקע. ונת, דברו אחד עם השני, תכירו אחד את השני. דברו עם בוגרי התוכנית, יש פה לפחות 2, עמנואל דלטורי, שהוא כוכב עולה באוניברסיטת בר אילן, הקים שם מרכז קוונטים, במרכז, למרות שהוא אסיסטנט פרופסור, כל הוא הצליח לגבש את האנשים שם ולהרים מרכז. יש להם מרכז מאוד מאוד מעניין. כרמל רוטשילד, שהיה אחד מהזוכים הראשונים, הוא היה מחזור מספר 2, שהוא במקרה סטודנט שלי, אז אני עוד לא הייתי חבר אקדמיה, והיום כבר, אז הוא היום פרופסור חבר בטכניון, הוא גם נמצא פה, והסטודנט הראשון שלו גם היה מלגאי אדמס. אז יש כבר כמה דורות. נלך לאכול, נשמע מוזיקה, דברו אחד עם השני, תכירו אחד את השני, ודברו איתנו, ופשוט תשאלו שאלות. אני אשמח לעזור לכם, וכל אשר תפנו, ובהרבה בהצלחה, לעתיד.